We will start with unit 14, which is probability. So let's go through the exercises. And before going through the exercises, let us go through some of the examples given in your textbook. So how do we define probability in general? Let us assume that I have a die, right? So a die has 6 sides and there is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? So what are all the possible outcomes of a die? So I throw a die, I can either get 1, I can either get 2, either 3, 4, 5 or 6, right? So all the possible outcomes of the die is 6. But if I want to know what is the probability of me getting, say, a 2. So the favorable event happening is 2 is 1 by the total number of possible outcomes, which is 6, right? So if I toss a die and I get 2, it is one outcome, one favorable outcome, whereas the total possible outcome is 6, okay? So 1/6 is my probability of getting 2. So similarly, 1/6 would be the probability of getting 5 and so on, right? So we start with the simplest of examples by taking a fair coin. So I have a coin, we all know that a coin has 2 sides, which is head and tail. So what is the first example given? Find the probability of getting a head when a coin is tossed. Also find the probability of getting a tail. So I toss a coin. So the possible outcomes. So this is example 1. Possible outcomes are either I get a head or either I get a tail, right? So there are 2 possible outcomes. So probability of me getting a head is the favorable outcome. That means I toss a coin, I get head. Okay, that's one trial divided by the total possible outcomes, which is 2. Okay, so for a given trial, say I get head, right? So this is one of the outcome, which is 1, head, divided by the total possible outcomes, which is 2, which is 1 by 2. It means that 50% of the time, 1 by 2 is 0.5, which is nothing but 50%, if I multiply this by 100. That means, if I toss a coin, say 1000 times, okay, 50% of the time I may get head, 50% of the time I may get a tail, right? So if I toss a coin 1000 times, it is most likely that 500 times I may get a head, 500 times I may get a tail. So this is what it means in general, right? So probability of me getting a tail is again 1 by total number of outcomes, which is 2, which is again 0.5, right? So let's go to the second example. So the second example states that a bag contains a red ball, blue and yellow ball, all of the same size. Kritika takes out a ball from the bag without looking into the bag. What is the probability of getting a yellow, red and blue ball? So yellow, red and blue ball. So there are 3 balls which are put in a bag, yellow, red and blue. They are all of the same size, okay? So what are the total outcomes? Either I would get a yellow ball, which is one outcome, I would either get a red ball, which is another outcome, or I would get a blue ball, which is another outcome. So total possible outcomes is 3. Okay, so what is probability of Kritika getting a yellow ball? It is definitely 1 by total possible outcomes, which is 3. Okay, so similarly, what is probability of getting a red ball? So one of the outcome, 1, that is a favorable outcome, is 1 divided by total possible outcomes, which is 3. Similarly, probability of getting a blue ball is again 1 by total possible outcomes, which is 3. right? So we have to realize that if we add up all the probabilities of all the favorable events, so if I add P of Y plus P of R plus P of P, what do I get? I get 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3 plus 1 by 3, which is 1. So the sum of all the probabilities is always equal to 1. So this is a very important point which has to be remembered. So let's go through the third example. Now suppose we throw a die once, what is the probability of getting a number greater than 4? And what is the probability of getting a number which is less than or equal to 4? So this is example 3. So a die is thrown. So we know that a die has 6 sides with numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so you throw a die, you may get any one of these 6 outcomes. So the total number of outcomes is 6. So what is the first case? The first case is probability of getting a number greater than 4. So probability of the event occurring. So we usually represent it as E, the favorable event occurring. So how many numbers are greater than 4? There are 2 numbers greater than 4, 5 and 6. So there are 2 favorable outcomes. So I have 2 favorable outcomes, 5 and 6, divided by total outcomes, which is 6. So it is 1 by 3. So next, probability of getting a number which is less than or equal to 4. Okay, so let me call it as P of F. So how many numbers, how many outcomes are less than or equal to 4? It is 1, 2, 3, 4. So there are 4 outcomes. So it is 4 by 6, which is 2 by 3. So again, we have to remember that P of E plus P of F is equal to 1. Okay, right? Also, this is a favorable event. Okay, so this event is obtained, can be obtained. So P of F can be obtained by 1 minus P of E, which is 1 minus 1 by 3, which is equal to 2 by 3. So if you have a favorable event, you find the probability. If you want to know the probability of the event which is not favorable, you have to subtract the favorable event from 1 to get the event which is not favorable. Because when you add up all the probabilities, it is equal to 1. Right? So P of E plus P of F is equal to 1. So what is P of F? 1 minus P of E. So let's go to the next example. So example 4. So once a card is drawn from a well-shuffled deck of 52 cards, calculate the probability that the card will be an ace and the card will not be an ace. So there are 52 cards in a deck, right? So how many A's are there? There are 4 A's. Okay. So what is the probability of getting an ace? So let me call it as P of E. Let me use the same notation. Probability of the favorable event is getting an ace, which is P of E. So there are 4 of them. So it is 4 by 52, which is 1 by 13. So what is the probability of not getting an ace? It is definitely 1 minus P of E. Okay? So 1 minus P of E is 12 by 30. Can I calculate it the other way? Yes. Probability of the event which is not favorable. So how many cards? So there are 4 ace cards. So how many cards are left over? You have 48. So this is P of F. So P of F is 48 by 52, which is again 12 by 30. Okay, so this is again a very simple problem. So next, let's go through example 5. So example 5 states that there are 2 players. There are 2 players by name Sangeeta and Reshma. And Reshma. The probability of Sangeeta, P of S, winning a match is 0.62. What is the probability of Reshma winning a match? Okay. So we have to remember that the probability, the sum of all the probabilities is equal to 1. So probability of Sangeeta winning a match plus probability of Reshma winning a match is equal to 1. So therefore, probability of R, Reshma winning a match, would be 1 minus 0.62, which is 0.38. Right? So the probability of Reshma winning a match is 0.38. Right? So again, we have to remember that the sum of probabilities is equal to 1. And another point to be remembered is the value of probability always lies between 0 and 1. Okay? So the minimum value of probability can take is 0. The maximum value of probability can take is 1. So next, example 6. So example 6, which states that Savita and Hamida are friends and Hamida are friends. So what is the probability that both will have different birthdays and same birthdays? So let's first talk about different birthdays. So ignoring a leap year. So in a year, there are 365 days. Right? In a year, there are 365 days. If both of them have birthday on the same day, okay, then you are left with 364 days. Right? So the answer for the second one is, if both of them have birthday on the same day. It's on the same day, right? It's on one particular date. Both of them have the birthday, right? So it's going to be 1 divided by total number of days, which is 365. So they just have birthday on one common date, which is 1 divided by 365. Okay, so what about different birthdays? Different birthdays? 364 days. So let us assume that they have it on the same day. So it is 1 by 365. They have it on different days. It has to be the other 364. So if, for example, Savita has it on 1st Jan, Hamida can have birthday on any other day apart from 1st January. So 1st Jan, let's assume that Savita has her birthday. So on any other day apart from Jan 1st, Hamida would have her birthday. So how many days are there? There are 364 days. So probability of different birthdays would be 364 divided by 364. Okay, so next we move on to the next problem, which is problem 7. which states that there are 40 students in class 10. Example 7, there are 40 students in class 10. In 10th standard, okay, there are 25 girls and there are 15 boys. So now a class representative has to be chosen. So what does the teacher do? Teacher will write the name of each, will write the name of each student on a chit, close it and put it in a bag, and she will take one of the cards. Okay, so now what is the probability of the representative being a girl, and what is the probability of the representative being a boy? Okay, so probability of the representative being a girl, how many girls are there? There are 25. How many students are there? Total number of students, 40. Right, so it is 5 by 8. So next, probability of a boy being a representative would be 15 by 40, which is 3 by 8. So again, to be observed, P of G plus P of B is equal to 1. And how can I get P of B? I can also get P of B from 1 minus P of G, from this. Since the sum of probabilities is equal to 1, P of B is 1 minus 5 by 8, which will give me 3 by 8. Okay, so next, let us move on to the next example. A box contains 3 blue, 2 white and 4 red marbles. Example 8, a box contains 3 blue, 2 white and 4 red marbles. So what is the probability of choosing the marble where the marble is white, blue and red? Okay, so 3, 2, 4. So how many marbles are there totally? It would be, so total number of marbles is equal to 3 plus 2 plus 4 equal to 9. So in a box there are 9 marbles. So what do I do? I just pick up one marble randomly. Okay, what is the probability of it being white? So probability of getting a white marble, how many white marbles are there? There are 2 white marbles. So 2 favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes is 9. Next, probability of getting a blue marble, P of B. How many marbles are there blue, which is, it's 3, divided by total number of outcomes is 9. Then red, P of R. How many red marbles are there? 4 by 9. So again, we observe that P of W plus P of B plus P of R is 2 by 9 plus 3 by 9 plus 4 by 9. It is again equal to 1. Example 9. So Harpreet has 2 different coins, say rupee 1 and rupee 2, okay, and they are both tossed simultaneously. What is the probability that she gets at least one hit? So I have two coins, okay? 1 rupee coin and 2 rupee coin. Both the coins have heads and tails. So I toss the two coins simultaneously. So Harpreet is tossing both the coins simultaneously. So what are the options? I make it head and head. Okay? So this is for rupee 1 and rupee 2. So both may be heads. You may get a head and a tail. You may get a tail and a head. And tail and a tail. So these are the only four outcomes when two coins are tossed simultaneously. So what is the condition? Probability of getting at least one head. Okay, that's the favorable, outcome. So let me call this as P of E. So I need to have at least one head. I can have more than one head, but at least I need to have one head. So there are four outcomes. So here I have two heads, one head, and there are no heads here. So at least one head I have, one, two, three outcomes. Total number of outcomes is four. So probability of Harpreet getting at least one head is 3/4. So now example 12, so there are 100 shirts, and then among these 100 shirts which have arrived, 88 shirts are good, 8 shirts have minor defects and 4 shirts have major defects. So there are two people here, Jimmy and Sujata. So Jimmy will only buy shirts which have no defects. So what is the probability of Jimmy having the shirts, right? So there are 88 shirts which are good, having no defects, divided by total number of shirts, which is 100, so it is 0.88. So for Sujata, so Sujata will accept good shirts as well as shirts having minor defects. So it's going to be 88 plus 8/100, which is going to be 96/100, so which is going to be 0. Example 13. So there are two dies, one is a blue die and the other one is a grey die, and both of them are tossed simultaneously. Okay, so here when I toss two dies simultaneously, so I can either get 1, 1. Okay, so let's assume that the first one is the value what I get from the blue die and the second one is from the gray. So I can either get 1, 1, I can either get 1, 2, 1, 3, 1, 4, 1, 5, 1, 6. Or I would get 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 3, 2, 4, 2, 5 and 2, 6. So similarly I have 3, 1, 3, 2 and so on, 4, 1, 4, 2 and so on, 5, 1, 5, 2 and so on, 6, 1, 6, 2 and so on up to 6, 6. So here I have listed out all the combinations when two die are tossed simultaneously. So you get combinations right from 1, 1 up to 6, 6. So there are how many outcomes? 36. Total outcomes. So what is the first case? The probability where the sum of the two numbers appearing on the top of the die is 8. So 8, I need to check for 8. So if I add these two numbers, it should give me 8. So I have 6, 2, 5, 3, 4, 4, 3, 5 and 2, 6. So how many are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So probability of me getting 8, is the sum is 5 by 36. So next question is, what is the probability of me getting 30? So the maximum is 12. So I can never get 13 when I add the two numbers on the die. So it is 0. Okay. So this is an impossible event. So when the probability is 0, it means that it is an impossible event in the sense that it cannot happen. So when you toss two dice and when you add the numbers, you will never get a number whose sum is 30. And what about the third one? The third one states that all the numbers should be less than 12. Less than or equal to 12. So here, probability of getting a number which is less than or equal to 12. Number which is less than or equal to 12. So I find that all the numbers are less than or equal to 12. So it would be 36 by 36, which is 1. When the probability is equal to 1, it is known as a sure or a certain event. Means it will always happen. So when the probability is equal to 1, it means that it will always happen. So a number which is, when the sum of the numbers is less than or equal to 12, it always happens. So whenever you toss two dice, the sum of those two numbers will always be less than or equal to 12. But here, 13, it is impossible, so probability is 0. So therefore, it is known as an impossible event, right? So we have discussed all the examples given in unit 14. So in the next session, we will try to solve all the exercise problems of unit 14.